Time now is 9:05. Regarded as one of the greatest ballet dancers of all time, Sergei Polunin shocked the dancing world when, in 2012, he quit his position as principal dancer for the British Royal Ballet.
Sergei was known as the party boy of ballet and struggled with the pressures of being at the very top of his profession. He's here with us now. It's lovely to see you. Now, a new documentary looks back at his career, revealing his life on stage. Before we speak to Sergei, let's hear about what prompted his decision to leave.
After his parents' divorce, Sergei's motivation changed, and he felt like, you know, what's the reason for me dancing? What's the reason for me pushing this hard? I think whenever you have a goal and there's no reason behind your goal with anyone, it's going to end badly.
Well, Sergei is here with us now, and Sergei, it's an amazing story you've got. Should we start at the beginning? You started dancing when you were very, very small, didn't you?
Yes, 3 years old.
3 years old. Yeah. And it wasn't exactly your choice, or was it?
No, when you're three, you know,
yeah.
It's not really a choice. It's my mother's choice. So she's a great visionary, and she kind of foreseen my future, and she put me into that.
And you were, right from a very young age, you were exceptional.
I mean, I worked really hard, and it was many hours. I did gymnastics as well, so
yeah.
It was 6 hours a day of physical work, you know, and homework and school. So, you know, when I was a kid, it was a lot of working hours.
Yeah.
So, again, the part of your story that people are more familiar with is the kind of meltdown, the things that went wrong later on when you're an adult. But going back in the story, you're 10 years old, and you're taken out of your environment, away from your parents,
yes,
to go to London. And there was a quote, and some of it's very emotional in the film, your parents talking about their sacrifice for you, and your dad saying, this little boy was our hope, that everything they did was for you at that point in time.
Yes, it's, you know, and personally, you forget sometimes what parents do for you, and you know, watching the documentary actually reminded me of things, you know, what amazing things parents do for kids.
Yeah,
you know,
it is very emotional, and kind of some raw emotion there as well, isn't there?
It is. It's, yeah, I couldn't watch.
Really?
You
might have to not watch now, because we're going to see, we're going to hear from your dad. Here's a clip from the program.
I did have a happy childhood, you know. My mom mainly raised me, but I loved spending time with my dad.
Не писали. Все детство до 9 лет практически я был с Алёшкой. Мы и гуляли, летом на пляже купались, мы с ним боролись, баловались. Я не хотел верить в то, что мы уже не будем жить, то есть.
And so, Sergei, just take this story forward a bit for us. You're hugely talented, and everyone's saying so, and you start working at the Royal Ballet, and then things go wrong for you. As you look back now, do you know why? Do you know what the reasons were?
I wanted to do more. I wanted to experience different things. I wanted to be in the movies. I don't know. I wanted experienced other things and a bit more freedom. Because when you're a dancer, you work really hard in a closed environment. And all you do, it's work. You never even grow up. So you stay childlike. And it's many, many hours, 11 hours a day, 12. And, you know, it's tiring. And being a foreigner as well in different countries. So it's, you're attached to your work, you're attached to your job. You know, if I quit Royal, for example, I leave back to Ukraine. So there's a lot of pressure, a lot of close pressure, and you know, you want to breathe.
Well, and then you had a different kind of pressure, because we saw a moment ago the headlines, and this was front page news here when you quit the Royal yes. Ballet, and there were talks about drugs, about your behavior. That's a whole new kind of pressure, a spotlight on you.
It was, and it stopped me progressing in a way. I wanted to go to America, I wanted to try different things, and it scared people after the bad press. And I was playing with the press, you know. I wasn't mature enough to realize what I was doing. You know, I thought it was funny and tweeting things, and I don't know, it was, to me, it was silly, you know, and I just dig the hole for myself, and nobody wanted to hire me after.
Right, which is really tough, isn't it?
Yeah, you feel like, you know, ground slipping away from you, and nobody wanted to accept me or took me seriously. Even in Royal Ballet, you know, I never missed a day, you know, I did every show, and I took work really seriously.
It's very clear that you put in those hours and made some extremely good friends as well from the Royal Ballet.
Yes, that's another thing I learned from the documentary. It's friendship. One of the most important things in life is friendship. And friends now help me tremendously, you know, they on so many levels. And you forget sometimes, you know, and it's a good reminder.
So from a very difficult place, you've managed to carve out now a whole new career where you go and work with people all over the world.
Yes, I'm doing my project now, and I want to change the system. I want to change the infrastructure of Bali. I think it's a little weak and it needs help. It needs something new. And I think managers and agents should come into the system. Dancers not represented well.
Right.
And I want dancers to be looked after, and for dancers to do what they want to do. You know, not just what they've been told to do. So we're gonna do movies about dance, we're gonna do live shows, and we're gonna support dancers the way we possibly can.
And you've taken a little step into movies as well.
And yeah, and I'm very, very happy. That brought me a lot of happiness. I'm working on a movie called Orient Express at the moment with Johnny Depp and William Dafoe.
And what is that like?
Unbelievable. 6 months ago, I didn't know I will ever be in a movie, and here I was sitting opposite William, and look at Judi Dench there, you know, Michelle Pfeiffer, Johnny Depp, and Penelope Cruz, and all this
wow.
amazing legends. You know, I had paintings of on my walls when I was a student. It's a surreal experience.
Well, we wish you well. I know you've got live performances, amongst other things, coming up soon. So thank you very much for coming to see us.
Are you enjoying the dancing again now?
I do, yes, I am, and I will be on the 2nd March dancing for Premier Dancer.
Brilliant. A Dancer will be in UK cinemas from next month.
That's it for us on Breakfast today.
You'll be back tomorrow from 6. You'll be joined by Chesney Hawkes as well.
Now, though, we'll hand you over.